Now, we know that there's no way we're going to be able to fit a tree to a non-additive matrix by definition of what a non-additive matrix is. But maybe we can construct a tree that is, in a sense, the best approximate solution for a given distance matrix. For example, consider the non-additive distance matrix that we encountered earlier in the talk, shown below, along with the following tree. To measure how close this tree is to the distance matrix, we need to compare the entries in D, i.e. uppercase D, with the distance between the corresponding leaves in the tree, i.e. lowercase d. The matrices are symmetric, so we only need to consider the entries above the main diagonal, of course. Now, for this example, notice that the red values disagree between the matrix and the tree. The distance from I to L, for example, is 3, not 4, which is what the tree indicates. And the distance from J to L is 5, not 4, which is what the tree indicates. So in general, we can compute how well a tree fits a distance matrix by computing the sum of squared errors between the distance matrix, uppercase D, and the distances between leaves in the tree that we're given, lowercase d. So to denote this sum of squared errors, we use the term discrepancy of TD. Now, for this particular tree, there are only two non-zero errors, both of which are equal to 1, and so the discrepancy is equal to 2. However, this is not the best we can do for this tree. Why don't you take a moment to see if you can find edge weights that provide a smaller value of discrepancy? Can you find maybe a provably best assignment of edge weights for this tree? In general, there is a polynomial algorithm that will minimize the sum of squared errors if we are given the structure of the tree T in advance. But in practice, we're not going to know the structure of the tree in advance. So we'll need to minimize the sum of squared errors over all possible tree structures. The number of tree structures is exponential in the number of leaves in the tree, and so unfortunately this least squares distance-based phylogeny problem is NP-complete. And so it's not going to help us fit a tree to a non-additive matrix, unfortunately.